Good evening, friends. This is Jasmine from Chennai, and I am the proud member of our group, Natural and Organic Garden Group, who has been administered by Abdulji. I wish to thank Abdulji for his initiative to make such groups for common cause, sowing for self-sustenance. And yes, friends, let's see our garden. You're all welcome to our little garden. This is the total aerial view of my garden. And the place where you are seeing the plantain tree is planted. And the tree of this tree, jackfruit, only that bit is the land, direct land area. Unless and otherwise, the other area are the area, concrete area, or else the area laid with the interlocked stones. So only this bit. This is the next bit of stretch adjacent to this kennel. Here I have planted this Aranelli recently. It is 2 weeks older, and the pomegranate, it has given its first yield. It's a near plant. And the papaya, it's 9 months. It is slowly giving out its flower. Actually, this also been affected by all that mealy bugs. Every day I'll be finding some, and I'll be destroying that, and I'll spray that, as Rohini ji always says, that rice washed water. Abdulji always insist rice washed water with citric fruit peels. Fermented for a day, and then it is being sprayed over underneath, thoroughly been given that wash all the time, and slowly it is giving out. It's only to my height and a little taller, and within this smaller area I have put some 6 varieties of plantain, almost 6 varieties of plantain are planted here. Each one is of one variety, and the first one is Nendram, the other one and that red banana, and this and all Karpura Valai, Ten Valai, Mondan Valai. So almost 6 varieties are here, recently planted. All is a direct land area. I always be mentioning that this much only is the direct land area and all. And I'll be becoming a little disheartening about that too, because always I'll be buying trees to plant. And but after being to our group, Natural and Organic Garden Group, I got wonderful ideas and tactics from our group. And recently, by seeing Abdulji's raised bed concept, see how I have extended my land area. This much land area I have gained through the tactics learnt from Abdulji's raised bed concept. And in this raised bed I have planted vallari, and also sowed green spinach seeds and all in this area. But after, because of the heavy rains here, southwest monsoon, all the top soil layer and my compost and also all along with that, the seeds have been washed away. But anyhow, we are all very happy about the good rains here at Chennai. And see this vallari slowly picking up. In a month or so, in another month, it will become lush green, fresh, bushy garden, vallari garden. And soon I will post the success story of this vallari. And also I am going to see sow spinach seeds again, sowing seeds for self-sustenance. This is the wonderful idea that I have got from our group, and now I have gained this much extended land area. Thank you. Hello friends, this is my Syngonium neon plant. At the start, it will be like this. This is the original color at the start. Once you started to crepe, it will not be that pink, it will slowly be in green color. But see, I have allowed it to crepe over my well top of my well. See, at every single node, it is giving out roots as well as new shoot. So this will be taken out and can be kept as a new plant. Likewise, this is another one. There are so many such plants. Every node, at every node, it is giving out new roots and also new shoots out. This many saplings could be can be got from this. So already I have taken so many and I have given my friends in new pots and also in new covers with a good fertile sand. These are all new shoots. Yeah, already I have shown in another video that always I'll be collecting this and keep in two ornamental setup. So on either side of a door or a gate it can be kept. That way I'll collectively keep have kept in two parts. So well, we keep on pruning and keep it in the stage itself, it will be always pink. Once it started to creep, it will be of green color. Monstera plant corner. Now people happily say it is Swiss cheese plant, Monstera. It was actually kept at my doorstep, two parts, one each on either side, and now it is growing big and I am keeping it near the wall here. It is creeping nicely and coming up with its full vigor. It's a Swiss cheese plant. Desert rose is also slowly coming up, and this is my another chili plant and with Dulasi. All our plants are being nourished by our kitchen waste and the garden waste, all made into a good compost, putting jaggery and other thing into it, mixed up thoroughly well and put it into pots over which the sand will be laid. So it's getting compost so quickly, after which it will be being supplied to all my plants once in a while. This plant is poinsettia. Poinsettia, the Christmas plant, will have its leaf pink like this. Totally pink it will be. Only during this chill weather it will become pink. Actually I am pruning it nicely and making it branched very highly. And every branch, if I slit it and put it in pots and pour water, make it always humid, it comes out nicely. I have given so many cuttings and little plants, saplings to our friends also. Those who are having it in a good climate like Bangalore and Elagri and all, they are having it fully pink. The whole plant is pink with them. But for me it is fully green because of the sunny weather. And here is a new one. I have now the branch broken and I kept it slantingly and put it inside another pot. It is coming up nicely, this plant. This one slowly picking up. My Syngonium. I will take all that new plants and keep it in a collective way. So it will be like a big bunch, as a bouquet it will be. I'll keep on either side of my door. It is waiting here to get it painted with that red oxide. So the pot will get painted and then it will be taken to the front door. So it is waiting for its painting to be done. After the rain only I should do it. It's all the new plant that is coming out of the new nodes, and it has been inserted into it, so it is densely and thickly coming up. So it is looking very nice also, rich and royal. This bushy plants also, its leaves are looking very leathery and rubbery. All fresh and green because of the rain washed it, and the rain water also gives it a big boost. So they are all very happy and enjoying the good rains. I am having two such pots on either side of my car shed. Nice new leaves are coming up. All are fresh and shiny. Hi friends, I need to say something new and special about our jackfruit tree. This is almost 30 year old, and it is always be shedding leaves every day throughout the year non-stop. So these such leaves are the rich source and raw material for my composts. Every day there will be some 2-3 tub full of leaves we will be getting, and this and all being get dumped into my compost pit. Sometimes I used to lay sand or compost over this, and directly will plant some croutons and all. Croutons and all will get easily picked up even over this. And this is the small, worn out, very old, given out, broken some. Previously in this metro water will get collected, and it is actually given out. They wanted to demolish this, but after I joined in our group, Natural and Organic Garden group, I come to know the importance of all these compost, before which also we compost. But a small pit near that twig, we will be digging and there we'll be burying the leaves, and the excess leaves and all will be thrown out. But after I am been to the group, I come to know about the very very preciousness of this compost. So suddenly this idea of using this sampasa compost pit sparked in my mind. So I consistently was telling that it should not be demolished, it should be given to me to use this as a compost pit. And now I am not at all leaving not even a single leaf, not even a single twig will go out of my compound. And even the banana tree, after it has been harvested, even that also will get cut into pieces and been dumped into, and very soon it is getting compost. But we haven't yet taken the compost from this pit till now. Soon we will be trying that out. But it is not too big, it is too very very small only. It is not very dangerously deeper, it is very small. So we can manage to take the compost. From one end we can start to take out. That's what we are planning. Thank you.